In this video, I'm going to discuss how to use ModelSim to simulate Verilog program. For this, I'm going to use ModelSim PE Student Edition 10.4A. The icon is available on the desktop. Just double click on the icon. It is going to load the ModelSim. Once the ModelSim loaded, close the important information window. Now go to the file, go to new project. It is going to ask you a project name. So I'm going to write the program for 3 input XOR gate. So I'm giving a name, my XOR gate. You can give any name of your choice. Click on OK. Here I am having a various option. So select create new file. You are supposed to give the file name. So I am going to give the file name my XOR gate. Then add file as Verilog. Click OK. Click on close. Here now you can see my XOR gate.v file. I need to edit this file, so right click on this. Click on edit. So editor window will open. I have already written the Verilog code for 3 input XOR gate using data flow modeling style. So just I am pasting that. The module name I have given, my XOR, ABC are the input, F is the output, input A, B, C, semicolon. Semicolon we use to terminate the statement, output F, semicolon, assign F is equal to A XOR B XOR C. I'm using a uppercase C. We know that Verilog is a case sensitive language, so this is going to give me the error. Save this. Now you can see a question mark in front of your file. Right click on the file, go to compile, compile selected. Now in the transcript window, you will be able to see the error. So we know that what is the error, so we will correct the error by making C lowercase. Save this. Again, right click on the same file, compile, compile selected. Now you can see in the transcript window that there is no error. The compilation is successful. Now program is ready for the simulation. Go to simulate. Start simulation. Go under work directory. So whatever the module name you have, you try to find out the same module under the work directory. So my XOR, I have selected my XOR. In design unit, it will be reflected work.myXOR. Click OK. In the object window, all the signals associated with 3 input XOR gates are available. Now I need to select all the windows, sorry, all the signals. Right click on this, add to wave. So these signals will be added to the waveform window. Now here I am having 3 signals, that is ABC input and 1 signal F is the output. If I want to group ABC, simply select A, B and C, right click, go to group, and because these are input signals, so I'm going to group them as an input signal. Click on OK. So these signals are reflecting under input. Now I'm having 3 signals and I want to simulate in such a way that I should be able to get the value of f for all the possible combination of a, b and c. So first I will take the signal c, right click on it, go to clock, and here first edge, rising edge. If you want to start your simulation with signal 1, you select rising edge. If you want to start your simulation with 0, you select falling edge. So I am going to start my simulation from 0, so I have selected falling edge. Okay, period is 100 nanosecond and duty cycle is 50%. So click OK. Now right click on signal B, clock, change it to falling, and here change the period of B, double the C, that is 200 nanosecond. Click OK. Now define the signal A, right click, clock, double the period compared to B, that is 400 nanosecond, and first edge is falling edge. Click OK. Now definition of signal A, B, C is done. So total simulation time I am going to set to 400 nanosecond. So I should be able to see the output due to all possible combination of A, B and C. Click run. You will be able to see the waveform. So here you have option zoom full. Click on the zoom full. So your waveform will fit into the entire waveform window. Now you can see for 000, our output is 0. We know that the XOR gate is odd number of ones detected at the input. So whenever the odd number of inputs will be high, it is going to produce output 1. So just click anywhere. It will show you the respective value of A, B, C and the output. Click somewhere else. The values are going to change. Now, coming to the grouping of signals. Sometime we write the Verilog code for a system in which we have some intermediate signals. So with this grouping option, we can avoid those signals into the waveform window. Also, if you want to delete any signal from the signal list, just right click and you can go for the edit and delete. But I am not going to delete any signal. So this is how we use the model sim simulator.